Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit an item response theory model called a one-parameter logistic model, or 1PL for short. I'm going to start by opening some example data called MASC1. So I'm just going to type web use MASC1. And let's describe these data quickly just to see what's in the data set. I have 9 questions. They're items from a test of some sort. And if I tabulate question 1, I can see that these are binary items. They're scored as zeros and ones. In this case, one indicates correct and zero indicates incorrect. And so what I'd like to do is fit this one parameter logistic model. So I'm going to go to statistics and scroll down to IRT, or item response theory. And when I click that, this will open the IRT control panel. So I'm going to begin by selecting model here at the top left. And then in my choice of models under binary items, I have one parameter logistic, or 1PL. And all I need to do is select the questions from my list of items. So I'm going to select Q1, Q2, Q3, and so forth. And then click Fit Model. If I go back over to Stata, I can see that the command that's generated by the control panel is IRT, followed by 1PL, which indicates the kind of IRT model I'm going to fit. And then I see a list of all of the items. So now if I look below my iteration history here at the top, I can see the beginnings of the output table. I'm going to click more so I can see the rest of it. The first thing shown in the table of coefficients here at the bottom is the discrimination parameter, which is 0.852123. And I can see its standard error, z-scores, and confidence intervals. And then below that, I can see the difficulty parameter for each of the items. This is one of the defining characteristics of a 1PL model. There's a single discrimination parameter that's constrained to be the same across all items, and then there are separate difficulty parameters estimated for each particular item. Now, if I wanted to see this organized a little differently, I can go back to my control panel, and I can select Report here on the left, and now I can sort by a variety of parameters. I could select sort by difficulty parameter. If I wanted them in descending order, I could check this box here. I might like to group the estimates into parameter classes. So I'm going to select this and I'll show you what that does. And I don't need to select the parameters because I can just leave this blank and it will do all of them at once. So now the control panel has issued the command estat report, followed by the option comma, and then the option sort B by the difficulty parameter. And then by parm groups them together as by parameter. So now I can see that all of the difficulty parameters are grouped together neatly in one in the table. Okay. Now, if I would like to see a graph, the item characteristic curves or other graphs for these parameters, I can go back to my control panel and then select graph. And the first thing I might like to look at are the item characteristic curves. So if I go down below where it says common graphs, I could begin by selecting all items. I don't have to select any items at all. I just click Submit, and Stata will create a graph that shows all of the item characteristic curves for all of the items simultaneously. But sometimes I might like to see just one particular item, so I can go back to my control panel, and maybe I'd like to see the ICC for question 1, Q1. So I can select Q1 and click Submit, and now I just see the item characteristic curve for question 1. Another thing I might like to do is add a vertical line that drops from the ICC down to the horizontal axis so that I can see the difficulty for this particular parameter. And if I wanted to, I could also select a second item so that I could compare them. So maybe I'd like to compare question 1 and question 5. I can then click Submit, and now I can see the item characteristic curves for each question. Now I could also... I might also like to plot the category characteristic curves. This will show the probability of someone answering, the conditional probability of someone answering in a particular category given their level of theta. So I'm going to do this for question 1. I'm going to plot the category characteristic curve, click Submit. Now what I see is the probability, the horizontal axis is still theta, and the vertical axis is still the probability, but it's the probability of either responding incorrectly, which would be Q1 equals 0, or the probability of answering correctly, which would be Q1 equals 1. So there are two possible outcomes. So notice as the theta or the overall ability is increasing, the probability of answering correctly is increasing as well. But as ability is increasing, the probability of answering incorrectly decreases. Okay. Now, I might also be interested in the item information function, how much information is contained relative to theta. So I can click submit again. And not surprisingly, most of the information contained in item one is for a slightly lower level of theta. We might also be interested in the overall test information function. So we can select that and click submit. And now we can see the overall information for the entire test. And not surprisingly, most of the information is around the area of theta equals zero because we don't observe a lot of people in the very high or very low ability range. And lastly, we might be interested in the test characteristic curve. So we could select that and click submit. And now we can see the test characteristic curve, which relates the value of theta back to the expected test score. Remember, we had 9 items, so the possible test scores ranged between 0 and 9. And this relates theta back to the expected test score. So that's how we can fit a 1PL model using Stata. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.